The Infested march upon the temple. Infused with incendiary power, Amon's minions set the ground ablaze as they die. Even more monsters emerge from the ashes, seeking to engulf the temple in the fires of their own deaths. Keep your distance and exterminate them. I was already wondering when we would once again have one of those mutation missions on the Temple of the Past. Now, of course, today I'm going to be playing it on the Brutal difficulty, and I'm kind of leaning towards Karax right now because he's really good on the Temple of the Past. But anyway, let's read the mutators. So first and foremost, we got the Walking Infested. Enemy units spawn Infested Terran upon death in numbers according to the unit's life. Okay, so we're going to see a lot of Infested Terrans then. We got the Alien Incubation. All enemy units spawn Broodlings upon death as well. And we're gonna assume that the Broodlings are also going to be spawning Infested Terrans according to their life, which is not gonna be a whole lot, but it's gonna be a whole lot of stuff. And then we also have got Scorched Earth. Enemy units set the terrain on fire upon death. You know what? I am gonna get started today with some Karax, I think. Yeah, I think we're gonna be focusing mostly on just building as much static defense as we possibly can, so I decided to set my mastery points accordingly. Now, the issue is that today, I don't actually have anyone to group up with, as it is rather early in the morning. So you know what? I'm gonna find myself a random ally, and obviously, we're gonna be playing on the Brutal difficulty. Alrighty, so here we are. Now, I'm gonna be focusing on static defense mostly.
Entaro at Doom, commanders. Our forces are engaging Amon's minions across Shakuras. But the Dark God seeks this temple's demise. It will take time to activate the temple's power and repel his assault. Your objective is to defend it until that time comes.
Alrighty. So, in case...
Running protection detail. Got it.
Chrono boost online. Our structure should now operate at a greater efficiency.
So, in case you are unfamiliar with how Karax works, basically he focuses a lot of his power on static defense. He definitely has some really powerful units as well, but really where he shines is just to simply turtle up as much as possible and to make sure that he's got a ton of static defense set up, just because there are so many upgrades for it and it really becomes extremely powerful, in particular once you finish up those upgrades. I don't think we need to actually rush out to second guess. Rather, I think I do want to go ahead and start setting up my defenses. Now, this particular mission, we win if we manage to hold on to the temple until the very end, then I think we're probably going to be best off if I just simply put as much static defense all around the temple and pretty much everywhere we can go. Apparently my probes actually weren't mining right there. Whoopsie daisies. That's less than ideal. Either way, I do want to make sure that I get the second gas going relatively early on as well. And obviously, I also do have the Spear of a Dude right here that I can use very easily. Now, it also has got a couple of really powerful upgrades that I do plan on getting rather early on into the game. But for now, I think we'll first and foremost right here get the optimized ordnance, which is one of the upgrades right here in the forts that will increase the usage, I suppose, of my static defense. Now, I do also need to make sure that I grab myself the expansion soon enough, so that is where we're going to be putting our initial priorities. The nice thing is that we can actually build static defense immediately, like without any delays or whatever, so I can just, for example, just put these stuff down, just like that. We'll put up two cannons. Obviously, that will serve as like sort of a defense mechanism a little bit later on into the game. You know what, I'll just attack the rocks here as well. Not entirely sure how good my ally is going to be. Looks like he's just setting up static defense as well.
Prepare to defend.
So they're gonna come over here first and foremost. We can actually hit it with the orbital strike quite easily. Don't think I want to really be using my orbital strike too aggressively. I think I'm gonna go ahead and use it after, you know, cleaning up these minions. There we go. So, as you can see, there are going to be Infested Terrans. Alright, I see how it is. Now, so far, though, there shouldn't be all too many units. I'm not sure if my ally is going to be able to quite make any Marines or anything just yet. And we may very well be relying on me here in the earlier stages of the game. It's all about, like, optimizing the amount of economy that you have, you know? So, right there, we do see the initial bit of... you know, aggression coming in, but we didn't manage to deal with it already. But I gotta be honest, that actually was a little stronger than I thought it would be. It was actually a little stronger than I thought it would be, but it's all good. So I'm gonna be chrono boosting out a ton of stuff as early as I possibly can. He's actually gone for straight up missile turrets as well. Maybe I should just set up my defenses a little bit closer to the nexus or to the temple. Not sure though, because I'm gonna need quite a little bit of space. We'll see. We'll see. For now, I'm gonna go ahead and grab myself another pylon. Just simply putting those close to my base right now as they build instantly anyway. And there's actually a little bit more aggression coming in, supposedly, right here from the site. Search ready. We'll see if he's good to go.
We are facing Terran forces.
Wow, there's actually a lot of stuff. All right, well, here we go.
Activating chrono boost now.
I did go for the chrono boost.
Greatly increase the output of our structures.
Now, this is going to help me out quite a little bit when it comes to getting probes. For the earlier stages of the game, that's really where I'm going to be looking for, ideally here, as much as possible. Main reason is, once again, that economy. I need to make sure that I get as much of it as possible. And already, we are done right now getting pretty much all of the economy that we are going to need for the remainder of this game. So I'm going to set my chrono boost over to watch the solo forge, as well as my normal forge here, and really get those upgrades out. And I think I do want to start getting my gateway here as well, because units such as the Energizer are still very helpful, as they will increase the attack speed and all that.
Detected. Marking location now.
Okay. I think we're,
We will have to be careful.
I think we're probably going to be, skipping the bonus objective, I think. Because none of us will really have, like, a really powerful army to push with. Considering he's got this much static defense already, so we'll see, you know. We'll see exactly what the plan is going to be. For now, I put down some more cannons. Make sure that I get another pylon here ready to go as well. Okay. And I'm gonna need to make sure that I get myself as much static defense here in the earlier stages as possible. Ideally, we do make sure as well that I grab myself these, shield batteries. They're extremely helpful, and they will help out a bunch as well. It turns out, actually, the defensive drone works well with Karax, just because he can actually nuke it down. That's pretty cool. Man, there's actually a ton of forces, though. Ooh, there are a ton of forces that are coming in. That's pretty insane. Alright, so the shield batteries have got a lot of sustain. They will help out a lot. As long as I actually manage to obviously, use all of the abilities. Just simply grabbing myself as much as possible and really setting up those defenses. I think for now, this will probably deal with the early game aggression. This will probably be enough here for the time being. Yeah, alright. So he's gonna go for some siege tanks as well. Actually, they're pushing really aggressively.
It has to be eliminated.
Okay, so we are going to need mobile forces, obviously. We are going to need some of it. I hope that my ally is going to be able to deal with it. I can use my purifier beam here to buy ourselves a little bit of additional time. Pretty sure it's going to be more than enough to clean all of this stuff up. There we go. And next up, I'm going to go ahead and grab myself this upgrade right here as well. And we'll make sure that we get ourselves the... Whoa, it didn't actually die? Oh man, that's a shame. I thought it would. We're gonna make sure that we get ourselves here the Twilight Council as well. Very helpful. Did actually end up dying or falling there rather early, but it looks like my ally at the very least knows what's going on and he's gonna be able to deal with it just fine. Okay. Gonna make sure that I once again chrono search.
Our structures should research and create units much more quickly now.
Okay. So this is where things get a little bit more tricky. I'm actually gonna go ahead and grab myself a couple of workers. It's because I really do need to start putting down some more static defense.
The temple have become unstable. It may be wise to dispose of them.
Okay.
Bringing a defensive drone online.
Man, they've got a lot of stuff here already. Wow. Woo! Okay, nice carpet bomb there, though. Making things significantly easier. I maybe should be focusing on a bunch more shield batteries. Okay. Anyhow.
Acknowledged. Thanks for the intel.
I'm gonna go ahead and grab myself the defenses right over here. Okay. Gotta be careful though in the bottom lane. There's actually a lot of forces there already. Gotta make sure that I move this thing over. And actually, oh no. I was not quite ready to deal with this just yet. I'm gonna need a lot more stuff here, though. There's a whole lot of Amon's forces, and I can't really deal with it for now. I spent a lot of my resources trying to hold on to my opponent's base, and I hope I'm not gonna be using, or I'm not gonna be losing my own here in the process. That would be unfortunate and not quite what we are looking for. Although it looks like we're once again going to be able to hold on here, at least for now. I hope. I did lose out on a lot more, though, than I was hoping for. Well, it looks like we're at the very least reasonably okay.
Defensive drone initiated.
Okay. The longer this goes, though, the easier it should become, just because we're going to be able to get a lot of stuff. But actually, there's still so many Amon's forces over here. Wow. That's insane. Not seeing a whole lot. Oh, man. They actually just managed to apparently kill my gateway as well, which sucks. Because right now, it's going to be really difficult for me to get a whole lot of damage in.
We are detecting hybrid.
And I lost my forge.
Hybrid combatants confirmed.
I mean, they're going to be pushing on all ends. I am pretty sure that this is going to be GG right here, right now, because I...
Half of the temple's configurations are complete. Remain steadfast until it can...
I mean, I would love to base... I would love to remain steadfast, but the issue here is that I don't have any army left over to really do anything with. I'm really looking right now to get some additional pylons or some additional defenses. I do have a pretty reasonable amount of income. And I'm still going to be able to make quite a lot of stuff. Do have my forge once again ready to go. That's going to hopefully help out. Okay. Oh, man. It gets crazy real fast. Yeah, I think if you lose income like that, it's very difficult to come back. Although, for now, it looks like we're holding on at least reasonably well. I have no way, though, of pushing away these Void Threshers. Unless I use all of my cooldowns, and I don't think we quite want to go there. Okay. Okay. Actually, I don't need that many pylons. I'm making a little bit too many. Once again, though, they're pushing real aggressively. Oh, man. I did do a lot of damage there, but they're just gonna keep on spawning more and more stuff. My forge is once again in a very vulnerable position, and I may very well need to remake another one, but I can't really afford it. Drop bots are coming in right now as well, and they're going to be pushing in from the eastern side, the northeastern part here, which is not that great for us, as I'm going to be losing... Oh man, there's no way! Oh my god, they're coming from everywhere! Oh, I love this. This is actually a real challenge. I wonder if Karax is even going to be the best option, because we probably need something a little bit more mobile here to really... You know, become... Oh, man. Oh, man. To really become a little bit more solid. And I'm worried here that we don't quite have enough. GG. So, this is going to be the second attempt. I think we're going to have to change up our strategy just a little bit. But first and foremost, I want to make sure that I don't just randomly lose my forge. Like I have done twice in their previous ones. I'm going to put it a little closer to the middle. Because if they manage to get that close, we are probably losing the game anyway. Other than that, I do think I need to prioritize where I'm gonna put my units a little bit more. So I need to make sure I grab my expansion a little bit faster, maybe with like a single cannon instead, and then really start bunkering up this part of the map, and then also the top side of it a little bit later. That's probably going to be our best bet, just because there's only so much I can defend, right? I'm gonna really need to make sure that I'm gonna be able to do as much as possible, but I can't defend everything. So something like this would work probably reasonably well, and then build like a big ring around it. So instead of like being at the outer edge, I'm considering here if I'm just going to build a little bit more inward. So hopefully that will allow my ally to move around a little bit faster. Now, I'm actually playing with a different ally. He's just also coincidentally playing Nova right here. But we'll really try and grab ourselves as much defenses here as we possibly can in the earlier stages. Now that at the very least we have like a reasonable idea of what is going to be happening here as well. So... I think I'm going to position my first pylon like right in the middle or so and put it like right over there and maybe put like one or two like to the other ends of it, but really just leave it at three, because I have a tendency to, for some reason, right, I have a tendency to just make a lot of pylons, which may sound a little bit silly, but it's pretty common obviously in the multiplayer that when you're going for a cannon rush, your opponent will actually try and, you know, nuke the pylons down, but obviously that's not really what happens all too often. We'll go ahead and spend some of our orbital strike energy on nuking down those rocks as well. Got a lot of energy anyhow. And I don't think we're really going to need it. There we go. And really still focus on that early game economy though. That's really still where we're going to shine the most. What are they going to be? So this time around is going to be Roach. Now, I've actually had some issues with this mission in the past. Whenever the opponents are going to be Zerg players. Reason being... is that they can actually make Scourge. In particular, in a later stage, it can be a kind of a pain, as they will just randomly start making a lot of stuff, and it will really just like fly and right click into the temple right here in the middle, which is oftentimes not ideal, but I think we'll be okay. So I'm gonna make sure that I get myself the upgrades here once again. Go for the gateway here as well. Really put my tech buildings closer to the nexus. I may very well want to get like a backup kind of fort a little bit later on into the game. Allies already nuking down the rocks, which is great. For search. Okay, we'll give him a smiley face. Obviously, once again, we're gonna prioritize, you know, getting as much economy here as possible. Ideally, though, I do want to get myself a bunch of the upgrades here as well. He's not saying a whole lot, so you know what? I'm just gonna go.
Our structure should now operate at a greater efficiency. Forces in combat.
Okay. And we really need to try and make sure that we survive the earlier stages a little bit more stably, just like that. He's actually playing this out really nicely. He's got a solid amount of economy already as well, which is great. And at this point, I think we can go ahead and grab ourselves the cybernetic score as well as another upgrade. Still going for the same composition, still not really changing a whole lot in that regard. But I do need to make sure that the Verily is going to be a little bit safer all around. Also, don't need to like make too many gas geysers. I've got a tendency to make a little bit too many, I think. I'm gonna put down my next pylon. And I'm actually gonna go ahead and grab myself another pylon like right over there or so. And then I want like right over there.
Acknowledged. Thanks for the intel.
Not sure exactly where that hybrid is going to be located just yet, but oh, there we go. So this way I should be able to start putting down.
It won't be long before it activates itself.
Should be able to put down a bunch of these things as well. I do want to make sure that there's a little bit of movement though. Okay. Actually, that spell is really good here, because obviously I'm going to be able to burn down all of the minions quite easily. We'll put some more minerals and info in there, and I probably want to make sure that I get, like, a couple of these dudes as well. If you can see, like, I'm trying to make sure that, at the very least in the earlier stages, we get some movement between all of the, buildings that I got set up over here.
Research completed.
Okay. So here we go. So far, so good. Make sure that I get this upgrade right here as well. Get myself the Twilight Council. And I probably want to start getting some of the buildings up here in the northern side as well. I think that's what we're going to be calling it. Should be able to get myself these energizers in a little bit too. For now, though. We'll have to make sure that instead that we really focus on getting ourselves this economy up as well. We also can't be called by, like, the drop pods.
Slay it before it deals too much damage.
Okay. So I do have my purifier beam. I'll see if I can save it for now instead. Probably a little bit smarter that way. And I also need to make sure here that I get these upgrades for my buildings and whatnot as well.
Army upgraded.
Here we go.
Upgrade not.
Good job. I think I may have very well wasted my purifier beam in the previous attempt, to be honest. It's one of the most powerful cooldowns in the game, and I didn't really get a whole lot of out of it. Well, here we go. This is looking quite nice. This is looking quite nice indeed. We'll make sure that we get... I'll get the solar efficiency here first. Okay, he's actually going to go for the bonus objective, which is fair enough. Okay. Try and move over. Actually, there's so much stuff. Oh my god. This is really powerful. Okay.
Mineral quantity.
Hybrid detected.
Hybrid. Warriors, stay.
He's actually doing the bonus objective right now. So risky, so greedy. Oh no. I don't have all too much right now, though. This army is still at the, there we go.
We have two more Zenistones to address.
His army is right now still hanging out at the other base. which is a little bit worrisome. Okay. I think we're gonna be able to deal with this though. Okay, this one at the very least is dealt with, and it looks like we have managed to hold on there for at least the time being. I'm just a little worried here for when like the big push is coming, when the drop pods happen as well. You know what? I'm gonna set up some defenses right here because I know how this goes. We get caught with our pants down while we're trying to defend all the different other objectives, and it may very well hurt us in the long run. Oh man, they still got so much aggression coming in here as well though. This is scary. They've got so much stuff. I'm trying to set up the defenses already for the next wave, right? Because I know it's gonna come, and I know it's gonna be an issue once we get there. But if I already lose right now, that would not be good either. So many things. Okay. Okay, so once again, we got some more pushes coming in.
Hybrid identified. If we work together, they should not be too serious of a threat.
The carpet bomb is gonna be really good. There we go. Really helpful.
The temple's preparations are proceeding as planned.
Okay.
Stay strong in your defense.
We've got about halfway done. So far, so good. I actually don't need this many pylons. Once again, I'm falling into the trap of adding on a lot more pylons for no apparent reason. It's just sort of something I always keep doing on Karax. I'll try and get myself another gateway here as well. Nova's actually doing really well here. Okay. Here we go. I think I am gonna go ahead and set up my defenses once again over here. Oh, we may need a little bit more over here as well, though. Okay. We just need to make sure that she can move through once my buildings really start clumping up. I don't think I'm going to be able to tech up quite yet to the final tier. Okay.
We are detecting hybrid.
Hybrid combatants confirmed.
Come on. Come on. There we go.
Slain a void thresher.
He's actually really good at killing the void threshers. Okay, here we go. So this is where the push comes in. The drop pods. Ally's already on his way over here, so that's great. That's exactly what we need. Really good. Trying to save here as much as I can. Obviously, there's also going to be some Nidus's and all that, more than likely a little bit later. Which is kind of terrifying, too. But really trying to get these Energizers in here as well. They're really good. They do energize the cannons. I think we can go for like another little... Alright, so here's the drop bolts coming in. I haven't gotten a whole lot of defense here in the bottom lane. So you know what? I think that's where we're going to be spending some of our money next. Okay.
Enemy drop pods detected.
Okay, here we go.
Nexus point under enemy attack.
As long as they can soak up the energy, we're gonna be in a fine spot. I'm moving my sentries about right now, by the way.
You must end its assault.
Okay. That never seems to come too much from the bottom lane, though, compared to the others. Ally is gonna have to move over, but it looks like he's gonna be able to deal with this just fine here for the moment. I think I'm going to be able to do quite a little bit of damage like that as well. I don't think I need to push over, to be honest. I don't really have the resources for it, and it's kind of like complete waste, you know, of resources. Although Nova can be called in that circle, though. If Nova dived, that's an issue. I do once again have my beam available, which is great. Are there any other upgrades that I'm forgetting about right now? No, I'm actually... Well, I could be getting this upgrade. I could go for the reclamation.
This just became considerably more difficult.
Okay. Here the pushes are coming in. Yeah, it looks like we are gonna indeed be skipping the bonus objective, which is fine. Combat. Okay.
Nexus point under enemy attack.
I wonder if I should just go for the beam here. That's quite a big push, and I mean, this is probably going to be our best bet. Trying to move my forces over here as well. Really dealing with all of the forces immediately as soon as they spawn, which is great. It helps out quite a bunch. You can go over there, I suppose. Hope my ally is still going to be okay. Looks like she is, so that's great. We'll go ahead and set up a couple more of the big cannons and really start working towards the center here. Once again, big push coming in from the north. Or the northeast. I've been calling... Like, the funny thing is that obviously the maps are, like, sort of tilted, right? So it makes it... it makes it hard to say which part is the north and which part is not. Okay. Oh, no, no, no. Nova, don't die, please. We kind of need you. You're pretty good. The area of effect spells are amazing. Okay, so the drop pods will be able to do a bunch of damage, but I think we're going to be okay. Okay, there we go. And I probably want to go for some of the big guns here as well.
Nexus point under enemy attack.
Nice! Really good drop there. Really good and nice push there. Although this is an issue. They're actually killing our stuff from the inside out. I don't see the lurkers. Although I'm assuming Nova already did snipe him down just now. Because obviously Nova is a detector. 5 more minutes remaining here. Now it's going to be nearly non-stop combat here for, you know, the remainder of this game. As long as we manage to hold on, we're going to be okay. As long as we can hold on to the objectives like this, we're going to be okay. The monoliths are going to be real powerful, though. And we've got a ton of stuff. He's actually... Is he going to move over to the bonus objective? I'm a little worried that he is. That would be terrifying. Oh, he's actually going for it. He's actually going for it. Okay. Well, hey.
It is almost time.
There is not much time left. We must fight with all we have.
He's actually going for the bonus. This is such a risk. I'm not going to help right now because I really need to. Obviously, he can teleport back whenever he needs to, right? I really need to save up the energy right now for my, what's it called? You know, the Spear of Adun, I suppose.
There remains one last Zenith Stone.
Okay. Looks like he is going to be leaving here, which is great.
Seems like we could use a defensive drone.
He's going to be capable of hitting this one home as well, I hope. There's a lot of enemy units here, though, and not a whole lot of Nova anymore.
Bringing a defensive drone online.
Oh no. Oh no. We got 2 minutes remaining. That's quite a lot of time. I've got a lot of forces set up. Really trying to stay alive here, though. Now, we don't really need to kill that last Void Thresh, I don't think. Just this one is... That one would be helpful. Okay. Trying to get as much static defense here as we possibly can. Is he going to be able to kill this one?
One hell of a healing device.
Almost. I don't have it quite yet. Come on. I'm trying. Okay. We've got a little bit more time. 1 minute and 30 seconds. Now, they are hitting the core or our temple like absolute mad.
Griffin's ready for boarding.
Okay, the Griffin has arrived here. So that does mean that Nova is going to be able to hang out. It's kind of hard to call exactly what is going on right now.
Cannot warp there.
Okay, we're gonna pull a couple of workers from here because I am losing them slowly but surely. A lot of aggression coming in. Leave the top one. Just survive. We don't need to. We don't need to have the top one. We don't need to have the top one. Defend the defend the temple instead. If we manage to defend the temple, that's fine. Okay.
Bringing a defensive drone online.
Okay, 2 seconds remaining. I think we got it. Whew.
The temple has been primed. Its activation will eradicate Amon's remaining forces. Well done, Commander.
That actually turned out to be significantly more difficult than I had anticipated. And for a little while right there, I actually did think we were gonna lose it, but it turns out because we turtled up like absolute mad and we had that mobile army of Nova, and actually I do have to hand it to our Nova player. He didn't really say a whole lot in this one, but he played extremely well and he did manage to most definitely carry his weight right there, if not, you know, outplay me in that regard. Very nice usage of the assault mode right there on Nova, using all of the area of effect spells extremely nicely. And while I think we could definitely have done it a little bit better with an ally that's going to be any weaker than the one that I grouped up with just now, it is going to be very difficult to make it work. I gotta say though, I like this little screen right here, with all of the static defense still visible in the background. Give me all that sweet, sweet bonus experience! Should be able to get another mastery level or two. Ooh! Yep. Ooh, that was actually real close. Nearly did not get that just now, but we are now a level 49 mastery player. Anyhow, if you enjoyed watching this video, definitely go ahead and hit me up with that like button down below to show your support. But while you're at it, definitely also make sure you subscribe so you get a notification when I upload next week's co-op mutation mission. Also, there are links to my Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook in the description down below, which would be really cool if you go ahead and follow me on there as well. Been trying to post on there really regularly, so if you want to keep up to date or ask me any questions or whatever, that generally speaking is going to be the easiest way to reach out. But other than that, I want to thank you all very much so for watching. Have an amazing day. Do not forget to smile, alright? And I will see you in the next one.